Let's focus for a moment then on the right to petition. What different forms can the right to petition take?
The right to petition can include the right to file lawsuits, legitimate lawsuits. It can include the right to simply ask the government to do something. It can include a number of different ways of making sure that your views get in front of the government. However you want to do that, whether it's responding to regulations that the government has put forth, whether, like we say, it is filing lawsuits, legitimate lawsuits, for example, or whether it includes lobbying the federal government, state governments, what have you, all of those things would fall under the right to petition as a way of trying to get some sort of power, or at least try to exercise some sort of power or responsibility with respect to the government, asking the government to at least consider the views that its citizens have.
Petitions need not be formal documents signed by groups of citizens. The right to petition can include informal petitions, such as faxes, emails, letters, and the like.
Why were the rights to assemble and petition important to the founders?
The right to petition and assemble were important because if you're going to make your voice known, it's very difficult for it to be as an individual. You want to make sure that folks can get together in groups in order to exercise any kind of democratic power that they may have. You want to make sure that they can get together to do that between elections, particularly if they're not allowed to vote, for example. When you consider the colonists, for example, who didn't have the right to vote in parliamentary elections, they're in a position where the way that they were going to move their positions forward was going to have to be through petition and have to be getting together in order to move those petitions forward. Without that right, they arguably had absolutely no say in government. Now, as we move toward the revolution, they started to believe that their petitions were being completely ignored anyway. So that provided just one more reason in order to make the break from England.